Okay, not just yet. My review of the tenders is flawless, amazing, never had anything else like it. Crinkle Cut Fries, perfect in every way. The sauce, amazing. Texas toast, hell yeah. And then the cane sauce, freaking good. And then the coleslaw, it's about average. I say 5-star review. Good job, Canes, or Raising Canes, or however. Until next time. Well, today I'm eating at Raising Canes. It was suggested to me by someone I knew. And I'm like, ooh, this has got to be good. So far, the Texas toast is amazing. The green lemonade is good too. Cane sauce. This is good. The chicken fingers taste a lot like regular chicken. The sauce tastes a bit like a chili mayo, but less spicy. Popular place. It's almost never not packed here. like a dollar or two a piece in California, SoCal no less. In one of the most expensive places in the world, of course people are going to be lining up for miles. Damn good for the price too. Combo's like eight for a four piece, but combo with the fries and the Texas toast and coleslaw. Well, that's really good though for the money. I mean, if you just wanted to get the tenders, I think they're like $1.36, $2 a piece. Include the drink, large drink rather. It makes sense that would be that much. Or in this town, other than here, you can't get anything under $10, it seems like, these days. Okay, you can still get box meals, but other than that, you won't find anything this good for under 10 or so. Right by my old apartment at 230th Street in the Copertranos. I ditched back all the way to when I had the meat lap warmer video. This used to be a Pier 1 Imports. But boy, did they remodel it. Wow. These Crinkle Cut Fries with the sauce are amazing. I'm just saying, for $8, I'm not complaining at all. I also took them for the meat for the road for an extra 10, for an extra $5. Also, it's they sell them made by the jug here, even. It's a large drink size. Not bad. For a couple bucks or so. This is way better than Popeyes. Oh my God. What the hell have I been eating all these years? No wonder they're so popular around here. And they got a double drive-thru. Ordered ahead with my phone because I said, yeah, for the place that's popular, I have to. They're more popular than In-N-Out, and In-N-Out started in California. Well, okay, scratch that. I think In-N-Out might be a little more popular, but In-N-Out has more locations than this, so it's hardly a contest. And then the last part of the meal, the coleslaw. Normally not a fan, but I'll try a little bit. I won't count it against them either way, because, you know, I already have a distaste for coleslaw that I know about. Yeah, not digging the coleslaw as much, but it's okay.
Anybody else got up?
Maybe with a little sauce. Actually, it's not so bad. It's actually pretty good. It's like salad if I think about it. That's actually pretty good coleslaw. Alright. I lied. It's good. At first I'm like, but, you know, now that I actually tasted it, it's good. Now I know where all the customers of Carl's Jr. have been coming when they're not there. This place is good. Look at that. Green lemonade. Oh my god. For St. Patrick's Day. Happy St. Patrick's Day, by the way. Thank you. This coleslaw reminds me of Asian salad when I dip it with the cane sauce. Really good. Got a little on my screen. Quite meaning. Do you have any napkins? Oh, here we go. That's our show today. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day.